43,000 Disney World employees. Matt, what a day. Great to have your voice with us to enlighten up all of us. This reopening there, the park in Orlando, even if it is slightly scaled back, is a major development and a big gamble on Disney's part, since Florida is still seeing a frightening number of new coronavirus cases, setting more single-day infection records just this week. We just saw what this means for visitors to the park, but tens of thousands of Disney employees are looking to you for guidance and reassurance about their safety. What are they telling you, and what are you most concerned about as the park partially reopens today?
Well, first of all, I want to thank you for having me. And, you know, you're right. There are tens of thousands of employees that have been called back to work, cast members in the Disney lingo, that have been called back in support of the park's reopening. But it's important to remember, you know, Disney's been operating at a scaled back, in a scaled back manner since May, since the middle of May, when Disney Springs opened back up. And there were, you know, a few thousand employees that were called to support that operation. Not surprising, there's been, a mass increase in the number of custodians that are working in the property, cleaning like crazy. Everything has been looked at. As far as what our biggest concern is, you know, our biggest concern is that we needed to be successful. The economy of Central Florida, moving these people, just months ago, we had hundreds of thousands of Central Floridians that were dumped into a very, very broken unemployment system. Mm-hmm. And so this is kind of a bright light for them to be able to return to work, get some sense of normalcy. So, you know, our major concern is that the guests that are coming in take the safety precautions seriously, that they listen to the employees, they follow the signs, they use the hand washing, that they take this thing serious, because we know that the employees, well, their livelihood is here. So the biggest concern is that everyone's working together, being patient, and make this successful. We absolutely need it to be a successful operation.
I hear you, especially on the economic front. But on the safety front, we know Disney delayed reopening of Disneyland in California because of the spread of the virus in that state, yet no delay to reopen Disney World there in Florida, even though it's as bad as it's been in that state. Does that make any sense to you?
Well, so I think that what you see is that, you know, Disneyland is operating with, to meet a different set of ordinances and things from the government there, that Florida does not have in place. As far as making sense, you know, Disney doesn't come to us, and it's not just me, right? I get the privilege to be able to come and to speak on behalf of the cast and on behalf of the Service Trades Council. But there's, you know, every union, we have six unions that are represented there, and every one of them have very strong leaders that partner with me every single day in the negotiations and trying to strategize, keeping things moving forward. When Disney announced that they were planning to reopen, we put our emphasis on how do we empower and equip the cast members, our members. How do we give them what they need to be safe? And so that was a number of different platforms, gauging the interests and the concerns of our members, and then going to the bargaining table and getting that. And so, to a large degree, we've done that.
Let me ask you about what you bargained for. Let me go through some of the safety measures that visitors to Disney World will see starting today. No parades, no fireworks, no hugging Mickey Mouse or any other characters, no fingerprint scanners, and this is a big one. Everyone over the age of 12 years old has to wear a mask. There will also be temperature checks, empty seats on rides to keep people separated, plexiglass partitions, thousands of hand sanitizing stations. Are you happy with these precautions? Did you have to fight to get any of them?
Well, our interest is that, I did a couple of interviews yesterday, and I've been very upfront. Disney has responded to the safety concerns that we have brought up on behalf of the members that we represent. And, you know, we expect that they'll continue to do that. One of the best things that we have at Disney that separates us from the other theme parks in Central Florida is that the employees that work at Disney World have a voice, and that voice is through their union, and they have a collective bargaining agreement. And so, you know, that separates, gives them, that empowers the employees to be able to make a difference in their working conditions. So when you look at the things that you just mentioned, there is no question that Disney World's experience is going to be different for guests when they come in. That's absolutely essential. It has to be. It just can't be business as usual. So it's going to be a different look. everything that I'm hearing from the parks inside inside the parks today, I wasn't able to be there today, I'll be there on Monday, but everything that I'm hearing from our staff and from the staffs of the other union is that guests are taking it serious and that it does seem to be a very positive experience. So to this point, the Service Trades Council and my peers have been convinced that Disney has responded to our safety concerns, and we are confident that they will continue to do that.
Well, fingers crossed it continues to be a success. As you said, this has to work for the livelihoods of all the cast members, as you put it, that you and your union represents. We hope it for them, and obviously we hope it for the larger public that's participating in all the Disney festivities. Thank you, Matt Hollis, for joining us.
Yeah, thank you.